Now, we're having talked a little bit about the etymology and the names of the four classes of Tantra. We can go back into our text. Yesterday, we stopped at the point where we were discussing performance Tantra. We have finished already the explanation of action Tantra. Within performance Tantra, we have covered the first and second parts, which is the type of initiation one receives and the vows and commitments to be maintained. And we're on the third part, which is the way to approximate the deity, the way to meditate on the path. Within that, we saw that there are two types of meditation: yoga with signs and yoga without signs. We have talked about yoga with signs yesterday when we explained how one meditates on the form of the deity that has been generated. And now we move into the second one, which is yoga without signs. We're on page six. Like second or third paragraph from the bottom. So number two is yoga without signs. When one attains calm abiding, focusing on the body of the deity, etc., one meditates on emptiness by combining it with deity yoga. One achieves the union of calm abiding and insight, comprehending emptiness through combining analysis and placement. So Umsha was saying that actually the advice that we have here is pretty similar to the statements that we have already come across in the context of action Tantra. First of all, one generates the form, the body of the deity, and once one develops calm abiding by focusing on the particulars of that form. And following that, it is important that one starts developing special insight, focusing on the emptiness of inherent existence of that deity that has been established. So after one has reached fully qualified calm abiding and is capable of holding the focal object with stability and clarity single-pointedly, one moves into the second stage, which is yoga without signs, where one contemplates the emptiness of inherent existence. And as we have said before, it is very important to alternate between placement and analytical meditation, because too much of one can harm the other. So you can see it's very clearly stated here. One achieves the union of calm abiding and special insight through combining this analysis and placement. And this word combining means alternating.
Senji zemi ji namjur ji don na se da ngoram di da jiro mu ji ngoram che mo ga lang di chang sema da ji wa nan ju ne tong ju gun ba da zhe bu lai yi gun di yan la se wo ji sema me ba ne tong ju gun ba da ji wa lai yi gun di la xia yi se da ngoram che mo na yang di song gu si na ji tong ju chong a gun ba la ma xia di si song ba ta ro se wo ji tong ju chong chong gun cha ga ji la zemi si gu ma re se Tanya Gum Goguivari, he cut in Zonzola, G. Mutengozo, some city the Anitina, he Kalayan Mubangan, Denny Yonji, Tangle, he quit and got on your day on gum. That change of a mercy, G. Shaker Shaker, Yon Zonzola, Yon Nicha attenti, Yon Zonzola, Nicha attenti, T. Chanjola, numbers of Devayana, Nuan, Roguivari, Yon, Namjiko, Sheriff, Gotti, Tango, Tombania, La Marshubashi. Oggi da dire che gogo yoa yendun dana tangye chong a gomba la ma sha si tangye chong chong gom jo ne chong ji ji sem da o da din da go nyam ne go sir sung go go re ma to thap ji song ri chok ge me chok ge yoa ma re wa thap ji ya de si ji de yen ba yen du oggi na na tangye chong a gomba la ma sha song a di song ni chim bu ji yen din.
Now, since we have introduced briefly this, the etymology and as well as some of the meaning of yoga with signs and yoga without signs, the author now continues by stating the tantric stages and to give us further information on these two practices. So it says, concerning the meaning of yoga with and without signs, the tantric stages states, yoga with signs is deity meditation and repetition without meditation on emptiness. Yoga without signs is deity meditation and repetition with meditation on emptiness, but it is not meditation on emptiness alone. So we say it's very clearly again stated, if you're practicing yoga with signs, you're not really meditating on emptiness, you're focusing on doing this, the focal object is the form of the deity, and as you're focusing with that, you will also be doing the repetition of the mantra. When it comes into the second type of yoga, which is the yoga without signs, we have a number of practices that are combined. It says it is deity meditation and repetition with meditation of emptiness, which means that although mainly your focus is meditation on emptiness, it doesn't mean that the form of the deity does not appear. At times your focal object will be the form of the deity. You will also be doing recitation of the mantra, and of course you will be keeping this recollection of emptiness. And the reason, again, that point is stressed in the following statement, where it says it is not meditation on emptiness alone. Because if yoga without signs was meditation on emptiness alone, it would mean that the two, which are method and wisdom, would have to be separated. But at all times, our meditation on emptiness or our practices definitely have to be influenced by them and qualified by the mind of bodhicitta, for example. Method has to be combined with wisdom. And if you continuously, you have to alternate, as I say, you have to combine these different aspects of focusing on the body of the deity as well as contemplating the emptiness of this particular form. It would not be appropriate just to simply concentrate single-pointedly on the form of the deity, because that would not allow you to develop your wisdom, your analytical wisdom that contemplates emptiness, but also would not be appropriate only to focus on emptiness. So you can see the point is stressed here very clearly. Do not separate method with wisdom. On this point, of course, there is a number of debates and a number of points to be investigated. So we start with a debate where it says, one scholar says that deity yoga that is not qualified and yoga that is qualified by the discernment comprehending emptiness is respectively the meaning of yoga with and yoga without signs. Right? So they more or less they give their own definition of what yoga with and yoga without signs is. And it says it all relies on being qualified or not by understanding emptiness. And the author replies to that, that should be examined because there is yoga with
meditation. Without that sign, meditation.
Oh, did that in the chicken? That in it, that
The reply to that was that should be examined because there is yoga with signs that is qualified by the discernment comprehending emptiness because it is said that if one meditates on emptiness prior to yoga with signs and at that time one has a strong discernment comprehending emptiness, the yoga with signs that follows after that will be qualified by it. And that is because it is similar to what is stated in the condensed stages of the path. So Nawam Peldon is not just making up an answer. He is quoting Lama Tsongkhapa in here. So what it says here that in Lama Tsongkhapa's text is that if one has a strong wisdom comprehending emptiness, when one is practicing generosity, prostration, circumambulation, etc., although the mind that is focused in these activities does not comprehend emptiness, it is not contradictory that it engages in the activities through the strength of that, right? So although it does not directly does it, it can be influenced through the strength of that. And then it says, similarly, if one generates strong bodhicitta at the beginning of the session and later on one engages in concentration on emptiness, at that time, although bodhicitta is not manifest, it is not contradictory that concentration on emptiness is qualified by its presence. So in other words, what they're saying is that if at the beginning of the session you generate either the mind of bodhicitta very strongly or an understanding of emptiness very strongly, whatever other practices you would do during the main part of the session will be influenced by this mind that was generated at the beginning of the session. And therefore we can have this influence, this support of method and wisdom.